Greetings and good morning. Hello everyone, my name is Patrick. This is something kind of new to me. I'm kind of doing a blog, a more professional style of blog. Normally I kind of only put little snippets together sometimes and just show them on TikTok, but this is kind of a more kind of 15 minute thing, I suppose. I see a bus coming, but I'm not too sure like which bus it is. And I'm going to see Depeche Mode, and this is going to be like nearly a 180 to 200 mile journey, or more, actually 250 mile journey. Woe betide me today. Woe betide me. Apologies about the light issues and stuff, just had to get up to check this bus. So, who would have thought that I would be going to see Depeche Mode, or many of us even. 5 years ago, Depeche Mode pretty much like split up. They absolutely hated the guts of each other. And because of lockdown, and the tragic death, like, you know, of Andrew Fletcher, of course, sparked off a new kinship, which made them like probably make probably in my opinion, their best album, Memento Mori. And here they are. In Slane, or I was going to say Slane, might as well be Slane because of how far away it is, Malahide Castle. For probably 50,000 people, like, are all going to be bunched in like together this evening to watch them play, probably for the final time. Because this is their 15th album, you know, they've been together for what, like 45 years? They don't really much like have anything left in the bin, and if they do play like again in the next few years, it'll probably be when they're in their 70s and it's their greatest hits. But we're very fortunate like to have them, like, you know, in our presence tonight. And I'm going to document, like, you know, like this vlog from beginning to end, just for your eyes only. And FYI, I'm nervous as hell, because no sooner like this gig ends tonight, I would be going to the Depeche Mode after party, and I will be documenting that as well, I hope. So stay watching, enjoy. Wow, I did not know that was there. I fucking made it, people. I made it. And the bus was late. Hours late. I can't believe my luck. More people coming in. Oh, my days. As I was approaching by, like, a seagull, like, was coming by, and he shit down on me. And that was, like, an indication of good luck. Oh, my good days. As you can see, people, like, were able to go upstairs. I remember, like, when I was at Longitude, I remember missing this bus because if you didn't actually buy online, even if you handed them like a paper note, pennies, whatever it was, they wouldn't accept it. This is so well organized, I'm so happy. But I'm bursting for a pee, and I'm afraid I could get sunburn as well. God help me, not with this Irish hail tan that I've got. Oh, rest of the blog later. Need something to eat first. And some beer.
Thank you.
So we made it to Malahide Castle. And it's 26 degrees here. And the bus driver was so funny. He missed the turn. And I think we just were there to make a fool of him. We're in this woodland here where a lot of guys are making piss. Because we're bursting, and I might go in one. I might go in somewhere here anyway. And yeah, I'm quite excited about tonight. This is only part one, and then there's the after party. Don't know what to expect. I'll be buzzing. How am I going to get to sleep? God knows. Wow. This is basically my birthday that I'm celebrating today, because my birthday didn't go too well. June 10th is my birthday, June 14th is today. And God, how can I put it this way? It was very non-eventful. So today I'm celebrating and everyone can fuck off. And yeah, that's that. Before I go in, I think I'm just going to come back here and make a pee somewhere. Wish me luck that I don't get found by a cop. I made it, people! I think I'm getting the chocolate dip.
Oh,
to any conclusion.
Thank you.
About that scene in Blade Runner. Jesus Christ. I don't think I will ever do a gig in Malahide ever again. I have to say one thing. Depeche Mode, like, yeah, I mean, they were good, but the sound system was fucking trash. Absolute trash. I know what my ears hear. Certain songs that sounded good, certain songs that sounded good. I think the Tree Arena is a better event than any of the other places, to be quite honest. You're going to, like, you know, go to a place, the Tree Arena, the sound is contained, the sound is much better. Don't go anywhere else. But it was my first proper festival, I guess, outside of Longitude. And Longitude, like, was better. It was much louder. The food was good and everything. The stands were good. The ice cream was exceptional. I forget who sold the ice cream again to me. But, yeah. You know, it is kind of sad that, in a sense, that this will be the last time I ever get to see Depeche Mode ever play, or we will ever get to see Depeche Mode ever play. But there's such an assortment of crowd. I was shocked to see so many young people. Assortment of 50-50 young people and old people, like, going to see Depeche Mode. They really were into it. I was into it now, in fairness. But there were certain things that, like, you know, as opposed to beer tents, €8 for a pint. Come on now, you're earning a lot of money from that fucking festival. Why do you need to charge €8 for a fucking pint? However, right now, the reason why I've left these glasses on, I'm very drunk. You don't want to see my eyes. And this, I found them on the road. Somebody lost them. It was some sort of knick-knack shop. And people lost stuff, you know? Even I thought I lost stuff, but I haven't lost stuff yet. And coming out of Malahide, people, like, did not know where the buses were. They did not know where the DART train was. It's been hell on earth, you know? I would say the experience was, nah. The concert was, nah. going to Dublin like on a very hot day, it's something I just would not recommend, especially if you're going to a concert and stuff. Going to somewhere like in May to the likes of Tree Arena, now you're talking. You know, I just think I'm far too old for it, to be quite honest. But you know, fair play, Depeche Mode, they did their job. And I can finally say I've been to see Depeche Mode, where other people have boasted 1,000 times on the internet, I've seen Depeche Mode and you haven't. But now I can say, fuck you, I have. And I've got proof. I haven't actually shot quite a lot of footage because, you know, it's better off like a finite footage myself on YouTube. Okay. I'm going to see like if I can make it to this event tribe, this event thing like that's going on, an after party. And I've got like, you know, the shades and the hat, just like Dave Gahan did in Personal Jesus. So, you know, I'm gonna stand out from the crowd. You people, you have an amazing night, and if I can film anything at all, I will. You take care. Adios.
lovelies. How are you all doing? Even though I don't look fresh, well, I do look fresh. I have a bit of a glow from yesterday being out in the sun all day. As you can see, I just finished having my breakfast here in Dublin before I go home. I stayed over Depeche Mode. Worth staying over for. I was at the after party last night. I stayed a bit late. Normally, I wouldn't have stayed late if Depeche Mode like wasn't the after party didn't happen. So it's 8:30 in the morning. It's absolutely scorching hot, and I'm going to have to like. I might take like a long walk down, or else I may take a taxi to get the bus to go home. But you know, like, I'm very worse for wear. I'm very hungover, and you normally regret feeling hungover, but I don't regret it one bit. That was a night worth living for. I'd live it over 1,000 times. Both yesterday and last night, but like, I swear, like, last night was even better again. At, what was it called? Oh god, I'm so over. What was it called? It's gone out of my head. It was like in Temple Bar area anyway. It's terrible. It's such a shame. But I will actually, like, you know, put it in the link in the description. It was, you know, like, it filled in like all the bits that you wanted with exactly the same loudness in speakers that Depeche Mode had live. It was like you were going to a Depeche Mode concert again. It was just wild and magical. May the rest of my 41st carry on this way, but a part of me like doesn't, because could you live this wild like every day with this amount of excitement? Anyway, that concludes this blog. And I'm going to fuck off down home to Lonely County Clare and look at some cows. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.